It's time for the taste. No. Okay, it's fine. I don't want to burn my tongue. Hello everyone, welcome to Home Cooking, and I'm here with my son, and today we're going to do this lovely seafood recipe. We're going to do fish fry two ways. So one is going to be an Indian style fish fry with all the nice masalas, and the other one is going to be a fish fry with lemon garlic butter sauce. Okay. Sounds exciting?
Yeah.
Yeah? Should we get started?
Let's get started.
Yeah, okay. So before we start, I would like to give a shout out to Anjan, my friend's son. Hey Anjan, your mom wanted me to share some nice seafood recipe with you because apparently you love seafood. So this is recipes for you. Hope you like it. So for any non-vegetarian, we need ginger garlic paste. So that's what we're going to do first. Shall we grind the ginger and garlic?
Yeah, that's okay. Good.
So we have about 10 to 12 cloves of garlic. You can just add it to the mixer jar. And I have two large pieces of ginger, just cut it into smaller pieces. So we're going to add that. And then you'll need a little bit of water. Okay. All right, I'll hold this. Yeah, just turn that on. Okay, that's fine, and that looks fine. So let's see how the ginger garlic paste is. So it's nice and fine. Can you see that?
Yeah.
So that's how we want it. Okay, so we'll just keep this aside. So for the marinade, we have a series of ingredients here. First, we'll add the ginger garlic paste. Yeah, add about 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste. Now, we have to talk a little bit about the fish though. So we have a nice fillet of red snapper here. 1 teaspoon turmeric powder. This one. It's turmeric powder. So turmeric powder is yellow, guys. So it's turmeric powder. Yeah, that's good enough. Yeah, that's enough. That's enough. Okay.
Then
we'll put 1 tablespoon of chili powder.
Can I have a tablespoon?
Yeah. 1 tablespoon chili powder. You want it a little more spicy? You want to add a little more? Okay. That's enough. That's roughly about 1.5 tablespoons of chili powder. And then we'll add 1 teaspoon of salt. Okay, that's enough. 1 teaspoon cumin powder and 1 teaspoon of pepper. So this is a very typical Indian masala that I make for fish fry. So that's what I'm teaching him. And of course we have basil. So this is basil, that is gram flour. Now this is optional. Add about 2 teaspoons, that's enough. So what happens is when you marinate the fish with the masala, it actually sticks well, and when you fry it, it really holds the masala in place. And the juice of 1 small lemon. So we have pretty much, we have everything in there. So we're just going to mix this. So if you need a little bit of water, you can actually add a little. See, you can see it's very thick. Shall I add a little water?
Yeah.
Okay. Just keep mixing that. So I'm going to add a little more water.
So with all the chili powder.
Yeah.
That should be enough.
So you see the consistency, it's not too thick, it shouldn't be too pasty. Maybe I can add a little more water. Yeah. So how does that look? The marinade.
It's like tomato chutney.
Tomato chutney? Yeah, I mean the color looks like tomato chutney, so. Okay, so what he meant was the consistency, right? So this is a good smooth consistency. So that's good. Before I apply it, do you want to taste it?
Yeah, sure, I'll taste it.
See if everything is okay. The spice, the tanginess, the salt, it's all good?
Yeah,
it's all good. So always taste before you apply the marinade. Just pour a little bit, then we'll just spread it across the fish, and then we'll have to turn it to the other side and spread the rest. Okay, that's nice, a lot of masala here. You don't have to get a big piece of fish like this, like a fillet. You can even cut it into half or make it into 3 pieces. So whichever works for you, it's good. Okay. So always marinate the fish. If this is the Indian masala that we're using, let it sit at least for a minimum of 30 minutes. It's good. Okay. I'm beginning to salivate just looking at the masala. Spicy, isn't it?
Yeah, it's spicy. So I put like one extra teaspoon
of chili powder. Just spread it across the fish fillet here. And we're going to just let this sit for about 30 minutes. So we've taken the pan, poured a little oil. So we're going to fry the fillet. It's been marinating in the masala. Look at that, it looks beautiful. So I'm just going to flip it over. So you can see all this excess masala that's sticking to the plate. I'm just going to put it on the fish. So we don't want to waste all that masala.
Ideally, you want to do this before putting it in the pan.
Yeah, that also works. Okay, so that's done. So we'll just fry the fish. So I'm just going to leave it for about 4 minutes on each side. So the fish fillet is cooking beautifully, you can see. It's got that lovely golden brown color. The masala is cooked. And the fish is really soft and tender. I've used a big fillet again, like I said. Make sure you use smaller pieces because I had a really hard time flipping it over.
Yeah.
When you do it, make sure it's small.
I saw all the struggles you went through.
Yeah, it was a bit of a struggle for me to flip it over. The fillet is a little too big. Okay, I think the fish fry is done.
How about the curry leaves?
Curry leaves? Yes. We're going to add some curry leaves, okay? Special ingredient that we usually add at home. Curry leaves gives a lot of flavor. So just fry that and put it onto the fish. So we'll just leave this and we're going to do another fish recipe, which is that?
The pan seared fish fillet
with a lemon butter sauce, garlic lemon butter sauce. Yeah.
So my mom's not here, so I'll be chopping the garlic for the next recipe. I'm gonna be adding a little salt to the garlic. It helps crush the garlic and it releases the juices in the garlic, so there'll be more flavor in the actual sauce.
So finish chopping the garlic. Is that enough or we need more garlic? I think we'll need a little more garlic because we're making the garlic butter sauce, right? So we'll need a little more garlic.
So I'll chop these as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
So for the lemon garlic butter sauce, we also need a little bit of coriander. So he's going to chop that. So if you want, you can also use parsley instead of coriander. So whatever is available for you, you can use that. Okay, I think that's enough. We've literally made a semi-paste of the coriander leaves here. Okay, there.
You wanted it fine.
Yeah. Okay, I think that'll be enough. We have the same fish. This is the red snapper. This is actually one whole fish and we've got two large fillet pieces. So let's make the lemon butter sauce. First, we're going to add the butter to the pan. It's about 25 to 30 grams of butter. So actually, both of us are Spider-Man fans. Both of us like Spider-Man. So actually, in his room initially, I had all Spider-Man posters and everything for him. So, okay, let the butter melt. You can use the same lemon garlic lemon butter sauce for prawns as well. You can make any seafood, crab, prawns, fish, all that goes very well with this sauce.
Can you use this for chicken also?
Chicken, yeah, maybe. I've never tried with chicken, but I've tried with fish, so it's nice with fish. Now, because it's a nice big fillet, so I've added a lot more butter. So the butter is completely melted, so let's add the chopped garlic. So now we're going to season it with a little bit of salt and pepper. So initially, we did add a little bit of salt to the garlic while chopping, isn't it?
I'll just put 2 quarters.
2 quarters, okay. That's enough.
How much pepper?
Pepper, maybe half teaspoon pepper. Keep the flame on low. Yeah, that's good. So that's half teaspoon of pepper. And coriander.
Not all of it?
Yeah, maybe all of it. It should be good. It already looks so good. It smells so nice. You can get the smell of garlic and butter. It smells really good. Are you getting that?
Yeah.
Yeah?
It smells great.
Yeah. Finally, we add the lemon juice.
Is it ready now?
Not yet. So we'll let it cook for about a minute on low flame. Okay. So let's turn off the stove. The garlic lemon bitter sauce is ready. I'm not sure if I should taste it, but it looks really good and smells amazing. I can't wait to have it with the fish. It's very hot, but let me taste. Okay, it's very I don't want to burn my tongue. It's very hot. Perfect. Nice. Very good. Okay. Now we're going to fry the fish. And then we will pour the garlic butter sauce onto the fish and we will serve it. Now we're just going to dust the fish fillet with a little bit of flour. So for that, take a nice plate. I'm just adding 1/4 cup of flour, that is all-purpose flour or maida. We're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of salt and 1/2 teaspoon of pepper. So this is basically, we're just coating the fish. Both of us are getting our hands messy here. So we're just going to mix it in. That's it. So what we're going to do is just coat the fish with the flour. So this is a nice big red snapper, the fillet of red snapper. Okay, she want to do that? I'll just place it. Yeah. Just flip it over to the other side. Yeah. So this is going to give you a nice crunch on the top when we're going to fry this. Okay, that's good enough. You want to flip it over one more time? Just get the flour and all those little crevices. We can just leave it. So now we're going to fry the fish that's been coated with the flour. So I'm going to take a nice wide pan, add a little bit of oil. Yeah, we're going to shallow fry that. So like I said, if it's going to be difficult for you to use a big fillet, you can just cut it into half. So I'm just showing this on camera so it'll look nice. That's all. That's pretty much it. Yeah, that's it. So we're going to dust off all the extra flour. We don't want so much of flour on the fish. So just going to dust it off. It's just a very light coating. I'm going to place it onto the pan, okay? Whoa, that looks good.
How long does this cook?
I think this will take about 3 minutes on each side. You can fry this on medium flame for about 3 minutes on each side. I'm just going to gently flip it. Be very careful while flipping.
That's going to smash.
Wow, look at that. You can see that coating? It's got a lovely crunchy coating on top of the fish. So that's why we're using the flour. I'm going to flip it over to the other side one more time. So it's about 3 minutes. Just make sure it's cooked on both sides. I think the fish is cooked. It's looking perfect. You can turn off the stove now. The fish fillet is done and we have the garlic lemon butter sauce. So we're going to pour the garlic lemon butter sauce onto the fish. So of course it's a big fillet and it will require this much amount of butter. So let's just spread it nicely. It's time for tasting, shall we? He's going to taste it. So, oh, the fish is cooked beautifully. How is it?
It's really soft.
It's nice, right?
It's really good.
See, the fish is very fresh, so it's cooked beautifully and it's perfect. And make sure every time you buy seafood that it's nice and fresh, and you must clean it well before you cook it.
I'll squeeze a little lemon.
A little lemon, a little bit. Wow, that fish is so soft.
Oh yeah, it's really soft.
Really, really soft. Oh, the flavors. Mm. The masala.
Very strong.
Masala is strong and spicy. Okay. Yeah, of course, we are adding all the Indian spices, right? So this is how we make it at home. Nice spicy fish fry. So today we've seen two versions. So one is a nice spicy fish fry and the other one is a nice mild subtle one. So whatever you want to try, you can try. We have shown two variations here. I think we enjoyed making both of them. Yeah?
Well, it's really fun.
Really fun. What would you want to try? Maybe if you want to try one fish.
The other one is easier.
Okay.
And this one,
it's a little spicy. Yeah. The flavors are a bit strong. Of course, you can have it with some nice rasam, sambar or rice. This would be perfect. But if you just want to have a fillet all by itself, then you can try the lemon butter garlic sauce. Okay?
Yeah.
All right. So catch you guys on another episode. We'll see you guys soon. Hope you enjoyed this seafood episode. We really enjoyed it. We had a few struggles too. We struggled with the fillet because it was really big. But make sure you get a smaller piece and try it at home. Enjoy. See you guys next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye.